Mid-April 1975. We're just back in Melbourne from a six-week national tour. We've already put down eight tracks for our second album, and now we've got two to go. First one up this session, side one track four, is Love's Not Good Enough, words and music by Greg McCainch. It's an unusual number for us, slow in tempo and bitter in mood. First on the scene, as always, Fred Strawks, our drummer, has more gear than the rest of us combined, so he needs plenty of time to get it together and set up before we appear. There's a separate microphone for every piece of Fred's kit. That way the engineer can balance the rhythm instruments separately and get a really gutsy sound from the skins. If Fred's problem is early starts and endless packing and unpacking, then tuning is mine. Bongo and I have a lot of melody work in this number, both together and in harmony, so tuning is particularly crucial. We're only recording the instrumental backing today. Shirley puts down the vocal in a separate session. This means the guitars are really exposed. Already, but in a recording studio you have to approach it very differently. You have to pull it apart and look at the individual sections, then work out ways of balancing one section against another. This is where Ross Wilson, our producer, is a great help. He's been in the music business for a while, a songwriter and lead singer for Daddy Cool, so he can look at our material in a pretty detached sort of way.
I don't know, we can try it a couple of ways, of course.
But there's a point where you've got to stop the chat and get on with the music, with the help of a rough guide vocal from Fred, so we all know where we are.
Ready?
This is the up-tempo section of the number. Greg wants us to be sure of the transition to the slow chords at the end of the song. Ross leaves us and checks the sound in the control room with engineer John French before we get down to the actual recording.
Okay, that seems to be coming together. Now we'll try putting it down without the vocal.
And make sure you keep it slow and smooth and precise. Try not to speed up every time we do a retake, because it's got to stay the same tempo every time.
Okay, this is side one, track four, take one. Side one, track four, take two. Grooving, but there were some very, very strange points. So I reckon you should concentrate on playing it smooth
and tight. And don't worry too much about the sound that's coming out in the studio,
because it sounds all right here. Just stick with the beat and keep it nice and solid. All right?
Take three.
Record and re-record over and over again. If it's not a mistake that fouls it up, it's the general feel of the performance. That's why we need the independent ears of a producer. We've got enough problems keeping the thing alive and together. But Ross hears it as a whole, and he has to judge whether the performance we record is good enough for repeated playings of the final disc.
Like I said, don't experiment too much. You should have your parts set by now. Just stick to them and try to keep it like you very first started off. Nice and enthusiastic. I know it's hard to do that when you're retaking over and over again, but it's starting to lose some of the original feel. Try and just sit with it.
Finally, 6 hours after we start recording, we have a take that Ross likes. And it's with our approval as the recording artist that it's accepted. At this stage, we've only got the instrumental backing on tape. 5 tracks of drums, 2 of bass, and 1 of each guitar. But the tape machine can record up to 16 tracks of music on the one piece of tape. So we've got a long way to go. take is accepted and Fred, Greg and Bongo can go home. Ross, John and I start to record overdubs on electric piano and guitar. I can hear the backing played back through the headphones so that I'm playing in time with the original recording. Solo is the climax of the number. It's pretty wild, so we get through a few takes before it's right. Shirley for the vocals. The first thing to get right is the distance between him and the microphone.
I'd like to be in love, but love's not good enough. Good enough of reason.
Move back a bit.
To be in love these days. There's too much.
A bit further.
Going on. There's too much that's going wrong. Going wrong to be in love these days. An old sweetheart is crying on a vodka wedding.
It's a lonely business recording vocals. Just you and your headphones and the mic. And two guys behind glass, listening.
He's playing it cool for a while. A new lover says, come on over here. Another wants a date right now. For some double talk and cigarettes.
Once he's recorded the complete vocal track, Shirley then sings one of the choruses again at a higher pitch. And on another track, we both sing an additional harmony line.
But love's just not enough, not enough to be in love these days. There's too much going on, there's too much that's going wrong.
Next up is Fred again with some percussion overdubs. First on the gong, then the beltry. The boobams require a specialized skill. Peter Jones plays them like a piano. He's the only musician outside the group who performs in this particular number. This is the last track to be recorded before the mix. This involves Ross and John and a lot of knobs and dials and wires. All the musical material has been recorded and is stored on the 2-inch tape. Now it has to be transferred to the master 1/4-inch tape and eventually to disc. It's during the transfer that all the action goes on. Sounds have to be grouped into left and right channels for stereo. More important, Ross and John have to decide what's to be left in and what's to be left out. What sort of sound is required and what the balance between all the instruments and between the backing and the voice is going to be. The mix requires the same sort of musical decisions that went into the recording of the number.
I want you to leave the drums out until the vocals start, and on that blip, blip, blip figure that comes in, it sounds much better with just bongo playing that, because that bit has got the piano and the guitar together. Leave out the piano.
Thank you. Once the intro is organised, the most important thing is to get the vocal sound right. There needs to be separation between the solo and the backing, so reverberation helps. But John also plugs in a phaser to get more of a space music feel.
Good enough, a reason to be in love these days. There's too much going on, there's too much that's going wrong to be in love these days.
Okay, that sounds pretty good. Let's have a go at it.
But love's just not enough, not enough to be in love these days. There's too much.
I want it to build as it goes along, so at the end of the chorus, when the gong crashes in, bring up the left hand guitar.
Section of the number needs a more frantic sound. For the climax, the usual balance is reversed. My guitar solo actually drowns out the vocal line.
Say that you wanna meet me.